Hi, my name is Celina. I'm a videographer and visual effects artist. I've been creating content here on YouTube and short form platforms about filmmaking and traveling. Today, I'll be breaking down how I created this clone glitch effect using Adobe After Effects. In this video, we'll cover rotoscoping, keyframing, and my favorite stylistic effects. So let's dive right into this video. First, record a clean plate video and then duplicates of yourself in different areas of the screen. Then we'll use rotoscoping to mask out these different images of yourself onto different layers, and we'll use a refined matte tool to just clean up the edges. I'm also creating shadows by using black solids and feathering them and then changing the opacity. Another way you can do this is also just masking out those original shadows on your clip, depending on how you shot the image. Next, to add this little glitch, we're gonna use wave warp. So let's add that onto our clip. We're gonna adjust the wave type to noise and then the width to 500, and then we're gonna keyframe the wave height from 0 to however much you want this glitch to look like. Then we'll just copy those keyframes onto our other layers. Okay, my favorite part is the stylistic effects that I love to use. First, we're gonna add the glow effect and adjust the intensity and then add keyframes onto the threshold. I'm also creating new white solids over the lamps in the image and the camera to create a little white glow. And we'll do this by feathering the mask and adding keyframes onto the opacity. Now I want to add some particles, so we're going to do this by bringing in a black solid and adding on the particle world effect. I'll change the particle to shaded sphere, adjust the birth size, change the animation to direction axis, and adjust the velocity, gravity, and resistance to control the direction of these particles. Next, we'll add some radial blur, and this will kind of distort the edges. Now, to create these flashy effects, I'll add in an adjustment layer and use the Lumetri color panel to keyframe the exposure and brighten it up. Now, for the final touch, I'll add this slight RGB effect. So we'll do this by pre-comping this and then duplicating this onto three layers. Then we'll add the set channels effect. I'll have the top layer on red, the next on green, and the bottom on blue, and then change the blending mode to screen. Finally, we'll adjust the scale with the top layer at 100.8, the next layer at 100.4, and the bottom one set at 100. And that's pretty much how I created this effect. Thank you so much, Adobe, for having me. Been a longtime user of the Adobe products since I was like 14. You can find me on my social platforms linked here, and thank you again. Peace.